Hello, my dear students. The first question is, what was Franz expected to be prepared with for school? The answer should contain rules governing the use of participles. Then question number two is, what had been put on the bulletin board? Your answer should contain news of the lost battles, drafts and the orders of the commanding officer, shocking information of replacing French with German. Third extremely important question is, will they make them sing in German, even the pigeons? Now students, here this sentence is angry expression of Franz. He learns that Prussians or Germans are very insensitive. He learns their cruelty. So your answer should contain insensitivity and cruelty of German people is revealed, okay, for which he is very angry. Next, very important value point of the answer is, nature is represented by pigeon, okay, and nature cannot be changed. We cannot make pigeon, okay, speak in any other language. So it is in the case of French people as well. Even French people cannot be changed to German. Alright. Therefore, this expression is very important. Okay. That nature cannot be changed. Indian will speak in their native language. Okay. Their mother tongue. It cannot be forgotten by any means. If somebody forgets their language, then they lose their identity as well. Let's move to the next question now. Why had the villagers occupied the back benches? The answer should contain, first of all, as a remark of their respect towards teacher, that is M. Hamel. Then compensate the loss of not attending class. Till now, Alsatians, be it younger generation, be it older generation, they were procrastinating their task. So here they have got the they understood their loss, okay, and they wanted to compensate that. Therefore, they were there. At least that very day, they will learn something because of M. Hamel. Now, only opportunity to learn language. That was the only opportunity. That was the very day, okay, where they can learn French language. We know that it is not possible, but wholeheartedly, their presence showed that they were repenting for their mistake. Okay, let's move to the fifth one. We all have a great deal to reproach ourselves with. Now here, it should contain voices repentance through this remark. M. Hamel voices repentance through this remark. M. Hamel was very sad. Okay, he was repenting for the mistakes of parents, he himself and children. Now children and parents were not interested in school. Parents wanted their children to work in the mill and factories, okay, and children, just like friends, they were not willing to come to school. They used to play truant. They used to run away from school, okay. This was the mistake. Even teacher M. Hamel someday assigned personal duties to the children. We know that M. Hamel is very dedicated teacher, but it is human tendency that we cannot continue a work for prolonged period. Therefore, someday, okay, some rare days, he wanted to have relief. He wanted to have leisure time. For that, he used to send children for watering his garden, okay, and he used to give holiday whenever he wished to go for fishing. So that also he counts as his follies. Okay, so this also shows that, you know, when he analyzes his mistake, this also shows that he was a great teacher. Okay, at last, let us see the character sketch of Franz. At first, he was a shrieker. He was a lazy boy. Then he disliked school. He used to play truant. Okay, he used to play truant. He used to bunk the school. He wanted to freak out instead of learning rules of participle. No friendly feelings for teacher. M. Hamel was very strict for him. He did not understand that whatever he is doing, that is for he himself only. Okay, books were nuisance for him. Alright, books that he carried were nuisance for him. Useless. Nuisance means useless things for him. So these are the character sketch of Franz. Let's move ahead. Then we see another question, question number 7, very important again. When a people are enslaved, as long as they hold fast to their language, it is as if they had the key to their prison. At first, you have to mention that political enslavement is a curse for any nation. Okay, there's a mistake. Any nation. Okay. Political enslavement deprives people with their identity, and that is true. No physical or mental freedom. They cannot do whatever they like. If they want to read, they cannot read. If they want to perform some task, they will not be able to do that. Okay. Dictates own rules. The attacker or enslaver will dictate their own rules. This ideal example, we can get Britishers example, okay, who had dictated their norms, their rules and regulations upon Indians, all right? And those rules are justified, some are not, but they had to follow these rules, all right? So this is going to happen when somebody will be enslaved. Next we find language saves. Language saves people from these problems. How? First of all, they will keep their identity alive. Okay, when their identity alive, they will understand that these many people are from their community. Okay, they get united, and we know that unity is a strength. Because of this is strength, okay, because of common language, they are together now. Because of language, they are able to discuss and plan something for the escapement. And then eventually they will be free. Okay, this is what you have to write in your answer. Next, let us move to the next important question from the book, that is from the story, the last lesson. It is all about linguistic chauvinism comment. Now, at first, you should start with a quote. Whenever there is long question answer, you have to write four broader points, four value points. Okay, we are going to mention a bit more, but at first you should use quotation in order to impress the examiner. Okay, so let us see. I have used this quote. Man is born free, but he has bound himself everywhere in chains. Because of human being, there is communism, regionalism, religion, nationalities, language confinements, etc. Okay? And all these are because of human being. They have made it. Now, man forgot universal brotherhood because they are divided by all these things. If somebody is not from their community's language, they debar them. Okay, if somebody from another country, we debar them. If somebody from not our religion, we debar them. And region as well, community as well. So because of all these things, we have been segregating our brothers and sisters. Okay, we should realize that all the people are children of same God. This is the fact that we have forgotten. We have become civilized and civilized, you know, in that process, we have become power hungry as well. We have become selfish and self-centered. We have not been able to think about our other people. We have not able to think about growth of community, growth of nation, okay, growth of earth, but of our personal benefit. Clear? Here in the story, we find Prussians forced their language upon Alsatians. Prussians had no respect and acceptance of others' language. And this is the definition of linguistic chauvinism. Chauvinism means taking too much pride in one's own language and not tolerating others' language and culture. Okay, so linguistic means language, and chauvinism means taking too much pride in one's own language. So here we can see Prussians were chauvinistic people. Okay, Prussians were chauvinistic people, but not Alsatians. Why? See, in the while teaching, M. Hamel says that French is the clearest and most beautiful language of the earth, of the world. Okay, so this also, alright, now Prussians, they wanted to rule minds and hearts of Alsatians. They wanted them to forget their own identity by snatching away their language. Alright? They wanted them to think in German so that they can erase their identity. Okay, and this is the, if you lose your identity, you will not have feeling for your nation. And this is what they wanted Alsatians to do. Prussians' plan was to make Alsatians forget their nationality. And M. Hamel warned his countrymen about this. Let us move ahead. And another point I should tell you, that when you are writing long question answers, you can give example of linguistic chauvinisms. When Britishers came to India, they implemented their language to us. Okay? And because of language conflict, India still is not able to have one national language. South Indian people, they don't agree with it. North Indian people, Northeastern people, they have different language. So we are not able to have one language. And this is the thing which is given by, this is the conflict which is sowed, which is shown by Britishers in Indian life. Okay, let's move to the last two questions. Character sketch of M. Hamel. He can be regarded as epitome of an ideal teacher. He was ruler wielding stereotype teacher. He was always found with ruler. Okay, and he was the teacher who wanted his children to learn whatever he teaches. Okay, and this kind of teacher are required in modern world. Next we find him strict and domineering. Okay, he is like a dictator, but it is not negative, it is a positive one, because it is for the benefit of children. Now shown as insensitive to the feelings of the students, takes pride in his affirmation and empathetic tone. Now, he is not insensitive at all, which is very much revealed at last when he cries while writing Vive la France. Not only that, when he shows, when he refers children lovingly, okay, when he makes them realize about the importance of language, then we find him sensitive, okay. And he is the one who takes utter pride in his language. He is a true patriot. Okay, he's a true facilitator, a guide, a philosopher, a patient teacher. Okay, on the last day we find him waiting for the children to write, read and take as much time as they want to complete the task. He was a true patriot. Okay, no doubt he was a true patriot, because he thinks about French, and even on last day he was thinking about his countrymen as well. At last he writes, Vive la France. Now students, Vive la means long live. They write about France. Vive la Indi. I'm giving you all points about India as well. Because for Indian people, our country is important. For French people, their country is important. But the feelings are same. Alright, so this will prepare you for the article writing as well. So let us find out the points. Youth lacks fervor of patriotism. That is undoubtedly true. Yes or no? Right now, they are not close to their nation. Ignorant about our freedom fighters. If you will ask anybody to name 10 freedom fighters, they will not be able to write. They are not bothered about the statues that are made in their locality. Not even when they get in the books, they are least bothered to ask about them. Focuses on regional, political and communal agenda rather than thinking about holistically for nation as a whole, okay, for the nation. So this is another lagging of a young generation. Lack of responsibility and transparency resulted in violence, group conflicts. Young people should be given responsibility, and there should be transparency. It is not that people are given responsibility and they are not aware about its transparency, be it regarding money, be it regarding duty, be it regarding anything else. Okay, because of transparency, there will be fruitful results, which is lagging in government institutions and other fields as well. Okay, because of which there are conflicts and violence. They want to know that, especially monetarily, they are not clear. Okay, how much money organizations and government is getting and how much money is being utilized in the cause of the nation. Alright. Next, secured freedom but failed to utilize its true perspective. We have got freedom from India. okay, but we are not able to utilize it in a proper way. All right, there is poverty still, there is treachery, there is lack of a national feeling. Okay, young blood should participate in politics, young blood should participate in changing the life of the country, and it is, can be possible when youth will take involvement. Good leadership and governance. Now, when somebody understands the situation, then only we can think about its governance. Okay, if young blood will keep themselves aloof, then we will not find good leaders and we will not find good governance as well. Okay, next we find revive the spirit of nationalism and humanism. Before nationalism, humanism. Okay, these are the two aspects which makes a person complete. So we should make them humanistic. Okay, we should make them learn humanity essence first and then stick feelings then. Okay, so by this we have completed all the important questions of the last lesson. I hope this will help you all in your examination. Thank you everyone. We will meet in our next video.